What's going on, guys? No Slack Novak here with another episode of Airport CEO. Now, I do have a lot of things planned for not only this episode, but the episode after this one. So, we're going to do a few things today, but some of the things that we do today is actually going to be kind of like a precursor for future expansions, and you guys will find out more about that here soon. First thing that I want to do right off the bat, we are going to add in like a little security office, because I don't like all of our security guards here. When they take a break, they're walking over here, which, I mean, don't get me wrong, it's not all that far away. But I would like for them to have like a little security office right here. I think this is a pretty good spot for it. So we're just going to do a little tiny bit of expansion here. We're going to do, I think that'll probably be enough. We're not going to have any, we're not going to have crazy amounts of security officers. You know what, if we do like a couch here, here, one, two, three, you know what, I think that'll probably be enough. Let's make it just one little bit more. Bam. That is going to be perfect. We're going to give them a small door. We're going to put that sucker, let's put it right here. Make it really super close for them. So our workers are going to build that. This is going to be strictly a staff area, a staff room only for security. So we're going to go room, staff, let's go ahead and assign that. And then let's go in here. We're going to clear all types of staff that can go in there. And the only guys allowed here are going to be security. Now, since they have their own little room here, we are going to go ahead. We're going to remove them from this one. So allowed staff types, we're going to kick them out of the office over here. And hopefully they'll leave. We have four security guards just kind of hanging out here. But hopefully they'll get kicked out and they'll move over here. Now, let's go ahead and kind of outfit this place a little bit. So I think we'll do a couch here, maybe we'll do a couch here. Yeah, this should be good. I mean, that's going to be 9 spots for them to possibly sit. And we could even do something like this. Give them like a little armchair on these sides over here. I'm thinking we'll probably just do like a plant right there. Yeah, let's do that. We don't need more seating. We'll do a large plant right there. Let's go ahead and give them a trash can right here by the door, and I think that's going to be good. I don't think they need anything else. Real quick, though, we are going to give them some sort of different flooring. Actually, no, we won't. We're going to keep it the same. Yeah, we'll keep that the same, just so it kind of fits in with the area over here. Let's see. What else do we want to do? So that's going to be our new security seating area, which is going to help, you know, just these guys travel to and from their posts a little bit faster. What I also want to do, so we're going to end up moving both of these check-in desks, which we can't really move them, so we have to delete them. Which doesn't seem like too many people are using them anyways. We cannot remove a check-in desk with assigned flights. We have assigned flights over here? Deactivate, okay, and we'll deactivate this one. And then now, we should be able to delete those, right? No, we can't. We can delete that one. Why can we not delete this one? It says we have allow flights scheduled there or something like that. It's active right now. See, closed, check and closed at 15:05. Okay. So maybe we have to wait until 15:05 for that to go. No. Is anybody over here? We have some flights scheduled over there. Oh, I see. They have like their own little thing. That's interesting. Baggage bay connection. Build queue. Are any of these stands like assigned over there? No. Nobody's assigned over there, so why can't we delete that? You know what? I guess we're just going to have to fast forward. Okay, we'll do that later. That's nothing that we can do later. So we'll go ahead, we'll activate that back up. And then we do have flights, two more flights. We have the one that's here right now. We have another one coming in later. And then on Thursday, we have two more flights coming in. So once those are all expired, I think we'll be able to delete that, no problem. No big deal over there whatsoever. Nobody is using the staff room over here, which is interesting, right? Because we did, it's open. The room is open. And security is allowed in there. Is it maybe because it's not a secured area? Let's try doing that. I don't think it's going to really matter too much. But we'll try that. Oh, they're in there now. Beautiful. Beautiful. As soon as I said it, they got up and they left. They went in there. Beautiful. Okay, so we're going to do that. I want to move that one again, like I said. We'll do that eventually. Yep, still got another flight scheduled in there. Now, it did say something was delayed, which, why is something delayed? Okay, it's gone. So, you know what? Now we should be able to delete that. Yeah, we'll definitely be able to delete it now. No? Cannot remove a check-in desk with assigned flights. Really? But there's nothing assigned. If I click on it, see, there's nothing assigned over here. You know what? We'll just deactivate that sucker. No biggie. Making lots of money over here from all these passengers. Beautiful, beautiful. Why are these guys not processing anybody? Stan connection. I mean, it's connected. Can change while Stan has active flight. That's really interesting. Why are these guys not checking these people in? Are you only really allowed like one check-in gate or something? That doesn't make sense, but you know what? Hey, that's interesting. So it's 129 people deboarded, which is excellent. They hit, oh wow, this flight, that's the most people I've seen on one flight in this game. 154 people. Boarding is completed. We only got 145 out of 154. Not quite sure why that's the case there, but you know what? Oh well. Whatever, we'll figure it out. Now, one of the things I said that we're going to do towards next episode, this is not something that we're going to focus on today, but I do just want to get this infrastructure here started. We are going to expand our foundation, and I'm thinking we'll probably do it all the way down there, which I don't know why it's doing it like that, one by one. Like, I don't know if it's an issue with my mouse or what, but and now it's working all of a sudden. Interesting. Okay, so we're going to go ahead, we're going to expand the foundation like so. And then I want to build sidewalk areas. But you know what, I think we're going to wait to do that for the next episode. We're going to need to connect the sidewalks over here so that people can walk. And then we're going to build something over here. And it's going to be pretty exciting. I think you guys are going to like it. It's going to be our baggage claim area. This right here is going to be like a pretty giant baggage claim area. And I have a pretty cool design that I'm going to end up using over here. And then over here, I think, is where we're going to do our little cargo bay. And then we're going to have to attach that to service road and have sidewalks and all that stuff connected there so that the ramp agents can go and work on that stuff. Now, one of the other things that I want to do is I really like these general aviation areas. However, I don't think they really fit into what we're doing with our airport right now. I kind of want to expand on our actual commercial flights, our medium stands. So I'm thinking, why don't we move these general aviation flights and why don't we kind of put them down here? They can have their own little special area. Let's see. What is this over here? What's the width? You know what? It doesn't matter. Let's just go build off of it. We'll eyeball it. We'll do, should we do grass? Concrete? Let's just continue with the asphalt. You know what? No, I feel like doing concrete this time. So, yep. This is going to work fine. This is going to work just fine. This is going to be our taxiway. So, we will do something like this. We'll leave a little bit of a gap for the road. And then we can go like bam, bam, bam. Again, we're going to have like the three little taxiway lane right there. So, then we'll do this. Bam. So we're actually going to expand our general aviation area. Let's go ahead and speed up the game. They can start working on that. And then we can start shutting these guys down. As soon as they leave, we are going to shut these guys down, kick them out, and not allow anybody else in. Because we're going to delete this area, and we're going to build another medium stand over here. Flights are almost done. Well, the flights are done for today. And we've got two more coming in tomorrow. So now we're making less money from these guys because it is overnight. Instead of getting $25 an hour, we're only getting the $13, but that's fine. We're at $672,000. We're not in any kind of danger of going bankrupt or anything like that. Kind of interested too, why? I mean, we have these guys assigned to what, like 7-hour shifts? Yeah, 7-hour shifts. Okay, they're switching out now. Oh, look at that. Yeah, they did a nice little rotation and bam. Wow. So, you know what? I think, are they doing 7 hours in one spot? So, like, I think the new guys came over here, right? Then this guy moved over here. This guy moved here. This guy moved here. And then this guy went on break. So, are they really doing 7, 14, 20? Are they doing 28-hour shifts before they go on break? That's ridiculous. Wow, that would suck. I would hate that job. I better be making really good money to be working 28 hours in a row. I'm talking like firefighter kind of cash, you know, where you work like 2 days in a row and then you have like 2 or 3 days off. That's the kind of money I'm talking about. All right, let's see. So our workers are doing this. You know what? We probably need to hire a lot more workers too. That would help, right? Let's go ahead. Let's deploy all of them because this foundation right here is taking forever. We're going to get all these new workers in here. They're going to grab a box. They're going to go finish out this foundation over here, which they're going to do pretty quickly. And then the rest of them, I need you guys to come over here and start installing these small stands because I want to get our general aviation back up as soon as possible. Now, with the general aviation right there, we're going to have to expand our service road. So let's do that. And then, you know what? We're just going to keep the service road as asphalt. So we're going to expand the service road over here. We don't need to expand it all the way over there. We'll just expand it to right there. That'll be enough. Then we'll make this a taxiway foundation, which we're going to do the... let's do the concrete. Just make it blend. So we'll do the concrete taxiway foundation right there, and that will lead up to that taxiway foundation. And then obviously we'll have to put the taxiway nodes down here, but we'll do that after everything is built. 5:09 in the morning. We've got one of our last flights coming in, which is excellent. These guys should be leaving here pretty soon. This flight leaves at 6:45. This guy over here is going to be leaving at 6:29. Oh, this guy left. Let's go ahead and close that stand. And then when this guy leaves, we can go ahead and kick him out too. He's going to leave at 6:39. So these guys are all going to leave pretty close together. Can't close stand with assigned flight. Okay, then let's close it. Let's not accept general aviation anymore. Can we? Nope, still can't close it. Oh, well. General aviation is gone. Close stand. Oh, come on. Close stand. Okay, good. Good, you good. Let's go ahead and delete this one. We'll delete this one over here, since that's something that we can do right now. Why can't we delete it? Demolish. Okay, cool. Yeah, they're going to demolish that one. They're going to go ahead. They're going to demolish that one. And then when these guys leave, we'll be able to do the same thing over here. Are these done? Those are done. Beautiful. That was quick. Oh, and then we do have... Okay. Oh, you know what? I think I put those the wrong... Did I put those the wrong way? No. I didn't. They're going to use the one... okay. So, I did that right. I just didn't extend the service road as far as I wanted to. Bam. Beautiful. We're going to be good right there. We're going to keep those closed for now, though. When are you guys leaving? 10:37, so pretty soon. And you are going to be leaving at 10:29. Let's see. Can we close? Demolish. Close stand first. Well, we can't. Okay, there it is. It's closed. Now we're going to go ahead. We're going to demolish. Yes. And we're going to do the same thing over here. Close stand. Beautiful. Demolish. Yes. Thank you very much. That's going to go bye-bye, and then with that going bye-bye, we're going to be able to install another medium stand over here. And then with that being said, too, I want to go ahead and I want to bulldoze the taxiways that we've got going on over here. So I think we want to do that. We're going to get rid of this, taxiway over here, or the sidewalk, whatever that was. And then we're going to do the same thing over here. Get rid of all those suckers. Beautiful, beautiful. We're doing pretty solid work right now. I like it. I like it a lot. So that is the last flight. We do not have any more flights coming in, which is actually how we want it right now. That is finished. Let's go ahead and let's slow down time and let's see, can we fit two medium stands in here, which I'm pretty sure we're going to be able to. Yeah, we could definitely fit one in right there. We could fit, see, and... And we could maybe fit one in like this. Yeah, you know what? That's something we could do. If we fit one in like here... Oh, man, that's going to be interesting. We're going to have to do a lot of demolishing over there on our in our actual terminal, though, if we do that. We could put one right there. And then we could actually do another one like right along here. Let's see, we have $150,000. You know what? Let's hold off on that for just a little bit. Just a tiny little bit. I want to get this going so we can actually get some cash coming in. So we're going to do our general aviation over here. We're going to assign that to all of these stands. That's going to be general aviation only. Let's go ahead and get the taxiway ready for them too. So we will do something like this. Connect that bad boy up. And then obviously we have to connect these over here. So just like that. And that should be good. That should be everything we need. Because we are going to have the fuel trucks ready to go. With us having 6 general aviation stands too, I'm thinking we probably want to add another avgas truck. Because we only have the one. So let's go ahead. Let's go into that. Which is in what? Procurements. Avgas fuel truck. Let's go ahead. Let's order one. And we have the 2 fuel trucks, right? The 2 jet fuel trucks. Yeah, so even then, if we do expand and we do the 2 medium stands over here, the 2 trucks should be able to service those 3 just fine. And it looks like that we left a little square over here. Let's demolish that sucker. And we're looking good. Some of you guys were saying, too, that we need to expand our runway. Which, I understand that you guys might have seen, like, an aircraft overshoot the runway or something like that. But, you know what? I'm going to leave it the way it is. If an aircraft overshoots it, oh well, it just overshoots it. And then, from what I can tell too, they released a patch now where we don't have to manually repair everything. Like the runways and the airplane stands, apparently we don't have to repair them ourselves. I think if we have like a chief information officer or something like that, that's something that they do on their own. That being said, let's go ahead and open these suckers up here. Open stand. Open, open, open. I don't think we're gonna have to do anything else over here. I think we're good, right? Set pushback point, all that should be done. And yeah, I think we might have to give them, no, they have the runway over here, the little marker. So we should be able to start getting general aviation flights here pretty quick. We don't have any yet. See, there we go. General aviation flights are coming in. That guy just landed. Do we have another one coming in? Like how the fuel truck immediately went over there. And look, we have another general aviation flight coming in. So we should start making some decent cash over here from these guys. I like this. We just expanded our general aviation from 4 to 6. So we'll definitely be bringing in more money that way. Now I'm thinking, should we get more flights in here? Or should we just kind of start working on the remodel over here? Before we do any of that though, let's go ahead and get rid of this. We're going to deactivate that sucker, and then now we should be able to bulldoze that. No, cannot remove a check-in desk with assigned flights. What flights do you possibly have assigned? SW-525, Acapulco. We don't have any flights coming in, man. That is interesting. Acapulco, huh? We don't have any flights coming in. That is weird. That is weird. I mean, are some of these flights going to like Acapulco or something? Let's see. You are going to Spokane International. You are going to Fairchild Air Force Base. You're going to Spokane International. You over here are going to McCarran in Las Vegas. That's got to be a good time. Did you guys see though that they had like an active shooter? You're going to McCarran as well. Yeah, like on the strip in Las Vegas, some shooter just started shooting off in like a country concert. And I mean, he killed like 50 people. I mean, it's ridiculous. Anyways, let's not talk about that. That kind of stuff just upsets me. But yeah, so none of these flights are going anywhere that none of them are going to Acapulco, which is what this flight says, that it has something scheduled to go to Acapulco, which I don't understand why I can't just delete that. Yeah, cannot remove a check-in desk with assigned flights. You shouldn't have anything assigned. So that's a little frustrating there. But you know what? We're just going to adapt and overcome. What's going on over here? Oh yeah, they don't have any actual... No, what if we close this? If we close that stand, will that get rid of this? No, it didn't. Unfortunate. Oh well. Also, we are going to want to demolish these walls over here. I'll bulldoze these suckers. I'll let these guys out. I'm sure they have families to go to. They would appreciate that, huh? Good, they're knocking that out. Now, so we are going to have to redo this entire area over here. Let's go ahead, and you know what, let's just bulldoze. From here all the way over here, let's just bulldoze all those things. We're going to kind of redo this area, and then I kind of want to bulldoze this door over here as well. That's no longer necessary. And then we're going to probably add in those two commercial gates. So that's good there. Let's go ahead and finish out this wall. Bam, bam. And we're going to kind of take away this security zone that we have over here. If we hold control, we can delete it. Beautiful. And then let's go ahead and plop those guys down. Medium stand, we are going to do the asphalt. And then we could put that sucker right there. And I think we're going to go ahead, we're going to rotate this guy, and we're going to do something like this. Bam. Yeah, that's going to look fine. And then we can kind of do our little foundation over here. And we are going to look pretty solid over here. Yeah, you know what? That's going to look real nice. That's going to look real nice. And then this medium stand here is going to have the road already connected over here to the service road. And then, oh, you know what, though? You're going to need a taxiway, which we can just expand this taxiway over here. Not a big deal. Not a big deal at all. I don't think. You, though, you know what? That might not work over here. Let's hold on. Let's pause. Because you're going to need a taxiway. So we're probably going to want to make this area a little bit smaller. So let's demolish this area right there. And we're going to have a smaller terminal. We're not going to have as big of an expansion over here as we thought. Because we are going to have to do the taxiway over here. Kind of forgot about that. Not a big deal, though. Not a big deal at all. Let's go ahead. We're also going to bulldoze the taxiway that we have over here. That was for the general aviation flights, right? So taxiway foundation. Let's go ahead and bulldoze that sucker. From, I want to say, here to here. We'll get rid of that. Hopefully we'll be able to get rid of this over here as well. If not, we'll just have to delete the road as well. But this is going to work out beautifully for us, I think. Let's go ahead and we're actually going to delete this foundation over here. So foundation bulldozer, let's knock that out. And then we might still have to do like one more square, just so we can get a nice sized foundation over here, or a taxiway area. Okay, so it looks like they did remove the taxiway right there, just like we wanted them to. That's good. Can we now place, do we have room to do another medium stand? Because I'd like to put that right there. Ah, man, that's going to be close. We're probably going to have to do one more square. Which, that's going to make it a very small area, but you know what? I think we're going to do it. So let's bulldoze this foundation over here. Yeah, that's going to be very tiny. Very, very, very tiny. But you know what? We're going to make it work. Adapt and overcome. It's just going to have to be a tiny little terminal extension. Good, good, good. Can we get rid of this wall as well, please? Mm-hmm. Get rid of that wall right there. And then we should be good. We can go ahead. We can add in that other taxi stand. Asphalt. Throw that sucker right there. And then we can go ahead. We can do the taxiway foundation. Which we're going to do the asphalt again. And then, yeah, they didn't really remove that, did they? Okay, fine. We'll just do it this way then. Bulldoze that. Did they bulldoze it? Yeah, they did. Okay. So now we should be able to bulldoze the taxiway foundation too, right? Let's get rid of that. Get rid of that, please. So it looks like they got rid of the... Oh, you know what? I think I'm bulldozing the wrong thing. There we go. Let's go ahead and let's put the service road down again. No, that's not a service road. That is the taxiway foundation. So we need to do the asphalt. Throw that sucker right there, and then that should be good. And then we can connect the service road again. And again, we're gonna do the asphalt. Bam, bam. And that is gonna be good. Now we can create the taxiway foundation over here, which we are gonna do, let's see, just three. Three should be enough, right? Taxiway foundation, yeah. One, two, three. You know what, this one's five. So you know what, let's do the same thing over here. Should be good. And we'll do the taxiway foundation over here. Taxiway foundation, asphalt, and we'll do the whole thing over here, I guess. Kind of an interesting shape right there. Let's go ahead. Taxiway foundation. Let's delete this. And then let's try doing it again. Just as like one solid piece. And then once we have these three medium gates, we are going to be able to do a lot of flights every single day. And from what I read on the Discord server, it looks like they are going to be implementing where you can do like automated flight planners so that you don't have to manually do every single flight every single time. They're just like recurring flights throughout the week. But not sure how soon that's going to be. I mean, it could be a week, it could be 6 months, you know, who knows. But I like that we're making a decent money, decent amount of money off of these general aviation flights. And I know I've said that in the past. But we really are getting a nice chunk of change from that. That being said, we have our little terminal area here, which we are going to have to kind of put a wall down. I don't know why they didn't. I guess it's because I kind of chopped off the foundation there. So we're going to do something like this. And then let's go ahead and we're going to bulldoze this wall here. Nope, bulldozed a little too far. Okay, so we're gonna be good. Yeah, that's a really tiny little extension to our terminal, but oh well, it'll do. It'll have to do. There we go. Beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Let's go ahead and place those taxiway nodes down, and then we should be able to start scheduling some more flights. Taxiway node. This sucker is gonna go down here and get connected right there. That should be working perfectly fine right now. We could probably open that up. Open stand. We're gonna cancel general aviation and we're gonna do commercial. No boarding desk. Okay, cool. That is a quick fix. Quick fix, no problem. Taxiway foundation. And we wanna do the five. So we're gonna go from here to here. And that should be good right there. That should give us what we want. Then we're gonna need the boarding desk. So let's do items, boarding desk. So since over here, apparently they were only using one, let's do that over here. We're only gonna use the one. And we'll put that guy like right, kinda wish we could kinda center it, but apparently we can't. So we'll just go ahead, we'll do that right there. We'll do a boarding desk over here in this really tight spot. Must be placed inside secure zone, okay. Very, very easy fix there. Bam. Now we can do the boarding desk. Yeah, that's a really tight fit. Really tight fit. I'm almost tempted. See, that would be an even tighter fit. Okay. Let's go with, what if we put it up against this wall? What if we just did it down here? I mean, we could definitely do it down here. Yeah, look at that. That'll work. We'll do the boarding desk right there. I know it's a little janky looking. It's kind of funny. But this could be like a seating area, and then we could just do the actual boarding desk down here. Because this is like this is a very tight fit. I don't like it. I do not like it. You know what? Let's give it a shot, though. It might not look so bad. It looks bigger than it really is because of the blueprint. But we're looking good right there. We need to attach this taxiway foundation or the taxiway nodes over here to the runway. And now we should be good. Just need to assign the boarding desk, connect the stand right there. These should already be connected, right? They are good. So this one can be connected over here. And now we should be able to open these suckers up. So you are open. Beautiful. You can accept commercial flights now. You are open. You can accept commercial flights. And you are already open. You're already accepting commercial flights. We just don't have anybody actually coming in here. Now, what is your little issue? I guess it just needed to be repaired. Okay. So now we should be able to bring in, you know, while we're at it, let's repair the runway too. So apparently, maybe the update didn't get adjusted, or we just don't have the board member needed to do the automatic repairs, which I think is more likely, that we just don't have the board member. So we do have the two new taxiway, or the two new airport stands. Let's go ahead, let's assign some flights real quick. We're going to accept some contracts. Contract, let's go ahead and do Swiftly. We'll sign that contract. We'll also do, let's see, I'm trying to do, I'm thinking of the airliners. We're trying to do airlines that we actually like, which I like Maple. Let's go ahead and let's do Skylink as well. And then now we should be able to plop all these guys down into the flight planner. Yes, we are going to be able to. So I think we're going to assign, why do we only have two stands over here? We should have three. This one is open. It is accepting commercial flights. And then I wonder too, somebody pointed out that we could actually rename this. So this is going to be gate, you know what, we're going to make this gate one. That's gate one. This is going to be gate two. Right, did that stick? Gate one, gate two, yes. Let's make this gate three. And, oh, open, okay. Enter, open, should be good. So now we should be able to do the flight planner. Good, beautiful. Gate one, gate two, gate three. So Maple is going to be gate one. Let's go ahead and schedule these suckers. We're not going to do too big of a gap. You know what, let's see. So that one's going to leave at 9. We'll go ahead, we'll do like 9:30-ish. And then, so we're just going to do this. We're going to separate every half hour. We're going to have flights coming in. So that, I'm guessing, is 13:30. So then we'll do 1400, which is 2 o'clock. And then I think we won't be able to do any more. Is that all we're going to be able to do? Oh, we could really squeeze that in tight. Okay, you know what? We'll do that. And then let's go back. Actually, let's go back to Maple. And then we're going to schedule them for Sunday as well. Which, as you can see, this is a very time-consuming kind of process. But, you know what? If you want to make money, it's not easy. You know, let's kind of squeeze that in just a little bit more. Just so we have a little bit of a gap for that final flight. So instead of doing like half an hour, we'll try to do like 20-minute intervals. And then this should be perfect. Bam. Yeah, that's like perfect right there. I want to say that's 20-minute intervals, right? So this flight leaves at 9:05. And this one should come in at 9:25. Or 1:25. Beautiful. So that's actually exactly how we want it. And then, so that's Saturday, that's Sunday. We can go to Monday and we can do the same thing over here. So, bam. 20-minute intervals, which is right around there. Bam. And, okay, yeah, look at that. We'll do a little bit more right there. And then let's go ahead and let's just schedule it all the way through Tuesday then. Fine. Okay, and there is the last flight. So now we had those three airliners, and we accepted all the flights that we possibly could, which that's at 44 flights. 16 and 14 is 30. That is 44 flights that we just scheduled. It is Saturday, and we have them scheduled all the way through Tuesday, which is, took a lot of work, But let's go ahead and fast forward. We should see a lot of business coming in here. Now, before those flights come in, I'm thinking we're probably going to have to do another check-in desk. So let's do that real quick. We have three gates. Let's have three check-in desks. We are going to rotate this sucker to do something like this. And then let's fill out that queue once we're going to be able to do that. And I still want to close that. I mean, I don't know. Maybe, you know what, let's activate it. And then hopefully it'll just kind of fix itself over time. Hopefully. I need these workers to come in here, do that, knock that out. Build that check-in desk for me. And then also, with us having these gates, we're going to have to do a bunch of actual gate seating. And I mean a bunch. So we'll do something like... I don't want to do it this way, because that's just taking up too much space. But, so let's do something like this. And then, yeah, see that... And we're kind of tight on space. We'll do gate seating right there. We'll do gate seating right there, and then we can kind of do some couches on both sides of that. So we'll do gate seating there, and then we'll do some more seating over here. And then we'll do gate seating throughout over here. Let's do just right in the middle. Yeah, just like that. So we should be good. Let's throw down some couches for them as well. Let's do... We'll do one of these numbers. Bam. And bam. And bam. Yeah, and they can kind of come in here, sit there. They should be nice and comfortable there. Let's give them a trash can. Let's give them a small plant. Make it, like, you know, look a little bit pretty. Do something like that. Do the same thing over here. We'll do trash cans on this side of the seating. We'll do some large plants right here, and you know what, right here as well. Yeah, should be good there. Let's make this look a little bit beautified as well. Again, trash cans on each sides over here, and then we will do the large plant, swing, swing, and that should be good. That should be plenty of seating for hopefully all these passengers that we're about to get. Now we do have plenty of airline staff, I think. I'm not 100% certain, but I think we'll be able to we'll be able to cope. We'll be able to do everything that we need to do. Let's go ahead and expand our little queue over here. And I'm kind of dragging on a little bit longer than I wanted to with today's episode. But you know what? I think you guys would probably prefer the longer episode over a shorter one. So, you know what? Let's do that. No, didn't want to build. There we go. Now that looks even. Good, good, good. What are you guys complaining about? What? Are you guys saying, like, you can't get through security or something? You guys can go through here. Loud person. Employees. Bathrooms, maybe? That looks kind of like a toilet. No, I mean, these guys... You guys can go through security right there. You guys should be fine. Area, secure. Yeah, it's a secure zone. You guys should be fine. If the people don't have an issue going through there, then you shouldn't have an issue going through there. And I see the people going through just fine. But you know what? That might be something else that we want to do. Do like kind of like an employee-only security check over here off to the side. Interesting. How are we looking? Do we have any flights in here yet? No, but the flights are going to be coming very soon. Very, very, very soon. Yeah, we just did a nice little massive expansion there. I like it. I like it a lot. This is probably going to be the screenshot for this episode. Get all these three flights in here. Bam. It's going to look nice. It is going to look good. Everybody's using the couches, which I like, right? If there's more comfortable couches, why don't you use those as priority? Which, you know, these couches are all getting used over here. And then the people that didn't get lucky enough to sit in a couch, they had to sit in these actual gate seats. Anyways, what's going on over here? Looked a little funny to me. Anyways, guys, I think this is going to be the end of the episode. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to take a quick screenshot over here just to kind of show our progress for the episode. Don't mind me. Bam, bam, bam. Knocking out this screenshot right now. And we should be good. We should be good. All right, let's go ahead and resume. Bam. We're going to be making a lot of money, too. Should be making a lot of money. Let's go ahead, before I forget, we're going to make it to where we can have two of the airport staff at each one of these boarding gates. We should already have that over here. We do. Good. So now we're set. We are set. Next episode, we're going to be working on that baggage system. We already did the little expansion over here. Before I forget, too, though, let's go ahead and put down the flooring. We are going to stick with the traditional flooring that we're using over here. Swing. And, yep, looking good. Alright, so next episode, I think I'm going to do a cargo bay over here somewhere. We're going to do the pretty cool little conveyor belt design, which I'll show you guys in the next episode. So be sure to come back for that. It looks pretty interesting, and from what I can tell, it works. Judging by from some of the guys in the Discord server that have actually used that before. Wow, look at this. Look at all these people. Holy smokes. That's crazy. I really hope. Can these guys not go in or something? Are these people trying to leave? Let's check this out real quick. I'm guessing these people are just trying to leave. A lot of people are, yes. So some people are showing up. And then some people are leaving. Alright, we just need some more buses to come in, that's all. We have car pickup zones, all that good stuff. There we go. Not sure why they're only using that one. Why are they only using this third one? There we go. Alright, yeah, we need, it looks like we need more bus stops too. So we might have to do a little bit of an expansion over here. Add in some more bus stops. Which, I know that bus can hold more than three people. Only three people got on that bus. Only two people got on that bus. That's ridiculous. Come on, guys. Get the hell out of here. You guys don't want to hang out at No Slack Airport. Which, I know it's a pretty sweet airport. But, come on. I'm sure you guys have families and stuff. Go home. Go home. Anyways, guys. That is the end of the episode. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed it. If you did, do me a favor. Hit the like button. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And hopefully I'll see you guys on the next episode where we actually figure out this baggage system. Until then, I hope you guys have a great day. And I'll see you guys later. Bye.